We in the Stop TB partnership, we were very much part of the creation of the movement with childhood TB. And I have to say that even in the beginning of 2010, when I joined here and with TB Reach, we started the conversation about childhood TB. TB Reach actually was between the very few that put money into projects on childhood TB in some of the most difficult environments, such as Yemen. And this comes from a previous life kind of I had in a European region in which we were doing a lot of work around childhood TB. So we were part from this movement, and we are very happy on putting attention on childhood TB. I think it's a crime to have 1 million children with TB that are sick every year. I think it's a crime to have 140,000 children dying with TB every year. And I think it's a crime that, you know, we were unable, before this buzz was created with a lot of our work in Stop TB Partnership, to even articulate how many children we had with TB. I think that says a lot about our capacity of foreseeing challenges. So GDF, as we know, was at the forefront of running and pushing out first DOTS, first-line drugs, the fixed-dose combinations, second-line drugs. So, of course, that GDF is at the forefront on pushing out as well the pediatrics. And, you know, and, we will work definitively with countries to make sure that things are happening. We are working very close with our partners from the Global Fund to make sure that, you know, money can be reprogrammed or used in a better way. You ask me what bottleneck I see. You know, the bottleneck is that I think we need to go united as a TB community and clearly describe and facilitate the understanding of the country programs of what it means to have a fixed dose a proper formulation for children, that it's tasty and it's very good and, you know, it's like easier and different than what we used to have. I think the more we can reach the countries and the more we can explain to the NTP managers about the importance of switching to this, the importance of ensuring that children and parents are really helped to make sure that the treatment is a success, the better it will be. A big challenge will not be money, will be the mindsets, will be the change in the way in which programs are ordering the pediatric drugs, because this is a change, like any change, it takes time to do. So we need to go united. And I don't know how much every partner that is engaged in this want to stay united. It's very usual in TB that we are very divided. We are unable to come together, and everyone is like trying to protect their own little kingdoms. And ultimately, it's not that we lose, it's that the patients are losing. And we should be smarter than that. GDF has a global mandate, and it will be able to help and facilitate any procurement of any type of drug from any country. Okay. It has to be, of course, quality assured, and, you know, it has to go through the, you know, processes that are in place. But yes, absolutely yes. We just need, as you say, I am not worried about making it available from either manufacturers or GDF or so. Mm-hmm. I'm worried for the demand side, because yes, you see with the bedaquiline, in spite of sitting on a donation program, United Spitting, staying on 30,000 regimens, we are just scratching the surface. And that's not because drugs are not available. That's because demand is not in place. So we don't have, we should be so smart. We should not have the same situation with this formulation, and we should be prepared to push it out of the door.
Okay.
So with countries' regulations is always a challenge. And it's a reality also that, the TB programs are not in the driving seat within the ministries of health. You know, they don't have enough power to accelerate. You know, it's absolutely correct that, you know, you cannot bend the regulations and the rules of a country, and that will be completely wrong. But you can accelerate things, and for accelerate, you need the political will. Yeah. Very often, our TB programs are not linked to the highest level, so they have to dig a lot and to push a lot to be able to link and to try and at least accelerate the process to have something in place. So I know South Africa Minister Motsoaledi is a champion for most of the things happening in TB, and I am pretty sure that he will push for this formulation to be rolled out. Push the TB-HIV integration since 2004, all of us, and again, we are making some progress, but we are not there. So, you know, to make sure that we enter through the mother and child programs as well, it will take a bit of facilitating and a bit of time. It will take also change in some policies, because in some countries, children with TB are not taken care by pediatricians, but by pulmonologists or lung diseases, which some pediatricians are happy, some are not happy. But if they feel this is, I have nothing to do or to say with this kind, with this type of people infected or affected by TB, then it's a different story. Actually, what I observe is that we didn't make big difference in terms of numbers, unfortunately. And let's meet together in Liverpool and look over the numbers together. But what I feel as a difference is that a better engagement. I think I feel a lot much more noise, many more patients and people affected, and families and communities and civil society and advocates. And we were also, you know, we built back-to-back our board, so we had a lot of high-level representation that stayed a bit here. We had the Minister of Mozambique, we had high-level people from India and China, you know, the deputies of Ministries of Health. We had Nick Herbert from the Parliamentarians and Lord O'Neill from Antimicrobial Resistance panels. And in addition to this, we had the fact that we had the parliamentarians coming and being part of it, even if it was in the beginning of the union, is bringing us a lot of political leverage. And more than anything, I think it was much more media coverage than before. And I think your work is paying back a lot as well. Yes,
thank you for that. Yes.
It is a long way that the union came. And you know, yes, when you know, I am a retiree almost from the union conferences that I attend, I think, since 97. So, you know, it's almost 20 years. And it used to be very technical, and it was to be very, you know, sharing papers. And I don't think there was that much media, for sure, not civil society. For sure, never a minister. Actually, I think last year in Barcelona, we started the tradition, and, you know, we worked very hard to make sure the Indian minister was there, the South African minister was there. So it was a much larger group. And I think I hope to keep it like this for Liverpool as well.
Yes.
We can do it. We can end TB. We can bend the curves. We must want it. And unless we want it, and unless we understand that we cannot leave anyone behind us, we cannot leave anyone suffering from TB without being diagnosed and treated and cured, unless we really are really faithful to this, we will not make it. But I'm sure we can make it, because we are a very smart community, the TB community.
Thank you. So much. Thank you very much.